Hey everybody, Flip and Dani here, founders of the Freedom Real Estate Group family of companies, and welcome to another episode of our podcast, which is called
Freedom Through Passive Income.
That's right, and welcome to another live episode.
In Ohio.
In Ohio, that's right. We're back in Ohio. If you didn't see yesterday's, well then we're just letting you know that we're back in Ohio for a week or almost a week. Today's Friday, of course, which Friday is...
Fun Shirt Friday,
that's right. And I did a little video, we're going to talk about that here in a second, but I did a little video about this shirt in particular. If you're listening and not watching, I'm sorry that you don't get to see this goodness. And you're probably saying, oh, he's wearing another Michigan State shirt. I'm not, actually. This one is a Disney fun shirt. And it's kind of weird because there's some skulls on it. But it says Disney and got Mickey on it in a couple places. But this is actually the shirt that started it all. There was one other fun shirt that I had that was from Disney, but this was the second. This was what made it a thing.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, now there's more than one, and this is it. This is the proverbial straw that broke the camel's back. So this is the shirt that started the whole Fun Shirt Friday. That whole thing. So if you're listening and only watching, or if you're and not watching, I'm sorry that you can't get to see this shirt. I'm sure that there'll be a picture somewhere of it. But anyway. So it's Fun Shirt Friday.
Yeah.
And we're ready to do our week in review.
That's right.
All right. This is week 41. Week 41.
Yeah. And this is our recap and key takeaways.
Yes. Yes. And there's only 11 more of these. Episode number 281, back in time. 3 years ago, key takeaway is, as we look back, we can understand the power that time has as it compounds all of our actions. We can see that by continuously forging ahead and taking small steps, they build on each other and can help you in your quest for financial freedom. But you, like us, have to make your own financial freedom a priority in your life and make time to continually move forward by developing and executing your strategy. Another takeaway is we recall that in 2017, we sold 5 deals and purchased 9. In 2019, just 2 years later, we sold 72 deals and purchased 50. That was a true growth spurt for us. We also created 3 new companies. Only 3? Wow, slackers. We also created 3 new companies, which brought our vertically integrated organization to 5 different entities. As we look back, we can see all of the little steps that compounded upon one another to bring us to where we are today.
That's right. And episode 282 was back in time, 1 year. Key takeaway number one, just 1 year ago in 2021, we moved into a new office with space for all of the staff and a warehouse for the renovations company and hired a CEO. We joined our first multifamily mastermind called Seven Figure Multifamily, and we joined Tim Bratz's group called Legacy Family. We also formed Freedom Capital Investments. And now we have, ownership in over 600 doors. Also in 2021, we recorded our very first podcast.
What?
Key takeaway number two. In 2021, we also created the BAM board, which allows everyone to see the flow of deals from acquisitions to sale and is an invaluable tool to our team. When we look back at our transactional growth in 2021, we sold 66 deals and purchased 94. It's hard to believe how far we've come in such a short time. As we reminisce about what has happened in the past year, it's unbelievable, but our journey, like yours, started with one step and another and then another. If there's one thing we feel compelled to share with you, it's please do not procrastinate. Your journey to financial freedom begins with one small step.
All right. Episode 283, Motivational Monday, 99 versus 100, which we just talked about this yesterday.
We did.
We're down to 31.
32 days.
Well, 31 now. Because it's Friday.
So
we didn't talk about this morning when we got up.
No, we did not.
So key takeaway for the 99 versus 100. Today we are going to discuss the principle of 99 versus 100 commitment level and how we are implementing this in our life regarding our health starting today. Wow, that was so long ago. When you have that 90% and allow for an exception, it opens the door for your commitment to falter. With us, it has been about how our health plan allows for cheat days during which we have taken some liberty. That's being so gracious. Some liberty with our diet. What we did was go all out and set a 12-week goal, but incrementalize it into 12-week, 1-week goals that allows us to focus on each step of our plan to get healthy. Another key takeaway is when you make a 100% commitment in your personal or business life, it is better than a 99% commitment that allows you to make one exception, then another. Allowing yourself an exception is an easy way to deviate from the path you know you need to take to, that can quickly turn a 100% commitment into 50%.
Mm-hmm.
As your commitment wanes, you begin to see reduced results and make more exceptions. Before you realize it, you lose your way. Applying the 100% rule to business by always being on time, always communicating in the way that you promised, and setting expectations leads to the development of trust and respect from your team and fosters relations with partners, vendors, and customers that leads to increased business. As we share our Freedom Through Passive Income information with you, we urge you to apply the 100% commitment precept to growing your investments and realize it takes commitment and discipline to reach your goals.
That is so, so, so true. Episode 284, Action Defeats Fear. Key takeaway number one, we generate fears while we sit or lay in bed for us. We overcome them by action. Fear immobilizes us. We don't take the steps needed to pursue our dreams because we become scared of failure, of not having time to follow through, or of getting stuck, of not having the right answers and not knowing what they don't know. And not knowing what we don't know is actually how I should have phrased that. Key takeaway number two, how does one overcome fear? Activity. Activity generates motion, which generates momentum, which creates the snowball effect in life and business. Make your first decision to take action, follow through on the action, and then you will be a participant in the snowball effect that takes you where you want to be. One other piece of overcoming fear with action is to always take action with accountability. This can be being accountable to your team or employees, or simply working with someone who is in your life who will hold you to task on the goals you set.
All right, episode 285, where attention goes, focus flows. I listened to that again. I'm like, I sang a song to that. What was I doing? I remember, key takeaway is, I remember taking a motorcycle trip where it was hilly, and rather than be distracted by the height and scenery, I focused on the road immediately ahead and realized that in business and life, you must always look to where you want to be going. Another takeaway is, just like the motorcycle trip where I followed Flip and focused on where I was immediately going, the same can be said for business. In our quest for creating passive income, we are always working to complete one step before taking another, and it is our team who we trust filters out our distractions and that we look to help manage us through the next steps in our journey to financial freedom.
Yeah, only one quick correction. Yeah, wasn't a motorcycle trip for us.
So there was two stories there. So there was a motorcycle story there with our pastor who said when he's riding his motorcycle, when he sees a pothole, he doesn't look at the pothole because otherwise he's going to run into the pothole. So there was that story. But then there was a story of us moving to Florida where you were following behind me. We were both driving vehicles, cars, and trucks. And you were following behind me in like the hilliest, those weren't hills, those were mountains.
Yes.
And so that's why you were staring at me.
Yes.
So that's correct.
The lesson was still there.
Yep.
And thank you, Joe, for always writing these recap and takeaways for us so that we can get, number one, a different perspective of somebody else who, you know, is writing down what they're getting out of the episode. And I think that's very helpful.
Yes.
It also saves us just a little bit of time.
That's right.
So thank you. Thank you, Joe. So our last key takeaways is for yesterday's episode, which was number
286.
Wow, 286.
I know, right?
So that was our live episode yesterday, and we talked about this before we started. Mm-hmm. I believe the very first takeaway was going to be I chose the three deals that we're looking at
right now.
That's right. So one in Mississippi, one in Ohio, one in North Carolina. Mm-hmm. We'll see how those go. And I encouraged everybody to go to freedomcapitalinvestments.com, join the investor club, because if we do end up going forward on any of those deals, they will likely be a 506B, which stands for buddy, which means the only way you're going to know about them is if you have joined our investor club and had a conversation with Ben or CJ. We have to have those notes on file before you are allowed to invest. So you could say, hey guys, love that deal, got it in my email. And we're going to look and see, did you have a phone call with Ben and CJ? Or do you know Dani and you and I have had a conversation? Any of that is fine, even Flip. We just have to have a conversation with somebody on our team. team. It could have been with Mark. It could have been with anybody on our team. If you've had a good, solid, substantial conversation with us about your investment goals, and we have those notes on file, and you say, I want to invest, then we can say yes. And if we don't, then we have to say no. And we'll have to have that conversation to allow you into the next deal. We can't have the conversation while a deal is live and let you in. So that is a big, big key takeaway that everybody needs to understand just a little bit more. So just keep that in mind. What was your key takeaway?
Last Wednesday.
Last Wednesday.
It was film day.
Oh, film day. Yes.
Marketing day. From 7:50 in the morning until 5 o'clock.
That's right.
That was a long day.
It was a long day.
Videos and pictures and drones. Oh my.
Yeah. It was fun. And we've never really kind of dedicated that type of effort to doing something like that. So it's really exciting that we got to do that.
Yeah. I can't wait to see the finished product.
Yes. Very, very cool.
Awesome. Right. Well, we hope you enjoyed this episode. Make sure you are heading over to the website, freedomcapitalinvestments.com, to join that investor club, because like she's talked about those deals, you do need to be a buddy, or have that conversations with us, those conversations with us before those actually happen. So make sure you join the investor club. Make sure you're checking out the website, checking us out on all the social media platforms. But we like to end all of our episodes with
invest smart,
live happy.
Bye everybody.
Nothing on this show should be considered specific, personal, or professional advice. Please consult an appropriate tax, legal, real estate, financial, or business professional for individualized advice. Opinions and information on the show are not guaranteed. All investment strategies have the potential for profit and loss.